this is a fiction with a science fiction idea about a dictator who is bringing in present a glorious face from the past. And with this, he's destroying his entire nation. We are all affected by politics. We are all affected by politicians. And it's, from my point of view, it's illogical to think that everyone's lives in this world, in this world, is out of politics. And what I want to show in my books is how the politics is influencing the people, how the politics works, how a politician think, how a normal people is thinking in contact with politics or politicians. From my point of view, I think we are not searching enough, and we are not looking enough to what is the real pressure of politics over each of our life, of our personal life, of our professional life, of our sentimental life. We are writing a lot of books about all those things: love, friendship, solidarity, pain, lost, whatever. But inside, above all of them, is politics, which more or less is affecting our life, and not our entire life, but every piece of our life. And I believe that because I think I understand politics, because I think I can destructurate politics, for me it's a great challenge to show how politics work, directly how it works and how it works in contact with other people. The idea of this book came to me from the book of Michael Crichton, Jurassic Park. The original title of this book in my language was Dacic Park. The Dacians are the ancestors of Romanian people. The Dacians fought with the Romans, they were defeated by the Romans, and from this mixture, they were conquered by the Romans, and from this mixture, it appeared the Romanian people. Romans with Dacians. And the idea I had, is if Crichton brought back from the ancient time dinosaurs to live with the men, and dinosaurs ate the men, what would happen if we are bringing back the old people to live with us? It's what happened in my book. You know, old leaders, old peoples, old armies, which are now marching through our streets in the 21st century. This was the idea. Let's bring history back. Why I did this? Because everybody is using history to justify the present. Okay, you use history. Okay, let's have history now. Let's have Vlad the Impaler with us. Let's see how he's doing. No, it's a big hero, but from 15th century, not from now. Don't think about him when you are doing now politics. Or let's bring him here. Let's have him here. Let's have, you know, the glorious army of the Crusaders now here. You want them? I don't think so. It was one step of the book. It was how a dictator could destroy a country because he's having an idea, and nobody stops him because nobody could stop him. And the other theme is, let's see what is happening if you are using history to justify the present. No, history is not about justifying. History is about academic. We must learn history, we must understand history, we must not use history.